In the tutorial, Identifying and Avoiding Plagiarism in Academic Writing, I mentioned that BU has some resources you can use to help you to create your citations, and you need to cite everything properly to help avoid plagiarism in your academic writing. So there are a few really popular academic citation management software packages out there. Perhaps the most popular one is EndNote. You may have used that before. Another very popular resource is one we have linked to from the library homepage here, RefWorks. RefWorks is completely free. As long as you're a BU student, faculty, or staff member, you can create a RefWorks account using this link here. I will say, though, that EndNote and RefWorks are very powerful and very popular, but they're getting a little bit outdated. The two most popular ones on this campus, especially for public health, are Mendeley and Zotero, and I'm going to talk about Zotero for the remainder of this tutorial. If you'd like to use Zotero, it is completely free. The first thing you have to do is to download the Zotero application for your computer. So I'm just going to go up here to the URL to zotero.org. As I said, this is completely free. It works for both Macs and PCs. I'm using Firefox right now as a browser. It works for Firefox. It also works in Safari and Chrome. Personally, I think it works best in Firefox. I recommend using it just for Firefox, but if you prefer Safari and Chrome, you can definitely download that version as well. So you notice here from the Zotero page, there's this large red Download Now button. If I were to download this, which I'm not, it's already installed on this computer, but I'm going to show you how this works. I would click here where it says Download Now. Sorry about that. Once I get to this page here, if I scroll down a bit, where it says here Zotero for Firefox, I would click here to download this latest version. The latest version as of today is 3.0.8. I would download that. Once I did that, Firefox would ask me to restart the browser. I'd come back to this page and then download the word processor plugin here for Word, the second step here. So I do, as I said, I do have Zotero installed on this computer. If I click right here where it says Zotero, this is going to bring up my library. I've been using Zotero for years, so I have quite a few things in my library. When you first make your account, you're just going to have this one option here, My Library, and you're going to have some of these options here at the bottom for groups and trash. But in this case, you just see, normally we just see My Libraries and then trash there at the bottom. Okay, so Zotero is very, very easy to use. The resource you're probably going to use most often in public health is going to be, journal articles. So I'm just going to start with the search in PubMed to find an article I could bring into my Zotero library. I know one of the authors I featured in an earlier tutorial is Paul Farmer. So I'm just going to do a search in PubMed for every article by Paul Farmer. So I'm just going to click here to get into PubMed from the library homepage. I'm just going to do an advanced search for the author Farmer PE, that's Paul Farmer's full name. So it's going to go here to advanced. I'm going to change this drop down here to author, and then search for Farmer PE, and then do a search. So PubMed finds 51 articles by Paul Farmer as an author. If I scroll down here a bit, the one that I had mentioned before with Jim Kim is here number 19, this article right here that mentioned that neglected stepchild as a phrase. So if I scroll back up to the top, you can see that there are 20 items on this page. It's nice that Zotero actually recognizes there are 20 distinct journal articles on this page. The way I can see that, if I look at the URL bar, there's a little middle of folder icon here. If I click on that, that shows me that Zotero does recognize all 20 of these items here. And again, number 19 is that one we used in an earlier tutorial with Jim Kim. So if I wanted to, I could say click on select all and pull all 20 of these right into my Zotero library. If I wanted to, I'm going to say deselect all and start over again. I could just choose that particular article we looked at before. But I tend not to like to do it this way. I like to tend to look at the abstract first before I pull anything in. So what I'm going to do here is, again, click on deselect all and then cancel this dialog box and look at one article individually. So I'm going to click here again on that article number 19 that mentioned that neglected stepchild of global health. Now that I'm only looking at one item, Zotero changes that icon from a manila folder to just a sheet of paper. So a sheet of paper is Zotero telling me I recognize this as being one journal article and I can pull it in. So if I look down here, you can see that I have a library with many, many folders and articles in there. I'm just going to highlight this new folder that I made earlier today. If you want to make a new folder, by the way, it's just this icon up here, this folder with a little plus to make a new folder. But I'm going to use this one here, just this new folder I made, and I want to pull this article into that folder. All I have to do is click on this sheet of paper. It's going to pull that directly into my library and directly into that folder. If I look at the view here in the folder, you see all the information it pulls in. So it pulls in my authors, it pulls in the title, it pulls in the journal title, it pulls in the pages, the date, all the information you would actually need to cite this article. Zotero pulls in for you automatically, which is nice. Most of the databases you use work just as easily. Web of Science is just one click. PsycInfo is just one click. You may see at some point, especially if you went to the public health orientation, there's a really popular public health database called Popline. Popline works a bit differently, but it's still pretty simple to do. But most databases you work with will have either that manila folder option for all of the articles or this individual sheet of paper here for one article. You're also going to use other resources though besides just journal articles. So say I wanted to use a book. Say I wanted to use the book Mountains Beyond Mountains about Paul Farmer in Haiti. You could certainly search the BU catalog, and BU does have Mountains Beyond Mountains, but to make it easier, you can always just search Amazon. Amazon actually has the biggest library catalog in the world. There are about 50 million books in print, and I think Amazon has all of those books in print in its particular database. So I'm just going to put in here that the same title, so Mountains Beyond Mountains. Sorry, I can't type very fast. And do a search. So I'm now searching Amazon for that book about Paul Farmer. And again, you can see that there is now a manila folder, so there are multiple items on this page that Zotero recognizes. If I just want Mountains Beyond Mountains, I'm going to click here to go to that individual item view. And you can see the icon changes from that manila folder, which means many items. Now it's just a book. So this little blue book icon means this is a book, which is different than a journal article. If I want to save this book to my Zotero library, again, I'm just going to click on that. It's going to pull that book in. So books are saved as information in a different way than journal articles. So a book needs an author, it needs a publisher, it needs pages. And all that information is pulled directly into Zotero from Amazon. It does a really nice job. It recognizes a different type of object than an article and pulls in the relevant information. Another resource you're going to use quite often, and by the way, I can actually just minimize this. I can still pull things in. I don't have to look at it. Another type of resource you're going to use really often are websites. So again, in that tutorial, one of the websites I mentioned in that tutorial was the WHO. So I'm just going to go to the WHO right here, so just WHO.int. So you can see that when I'm in here, Zotero does recognize a few thousand web pages as being web pages. This little blue sheet of paper here is the Zotero icon for a web page. So if I wanted to save this particular page, or say I wanted to go to a more kind of specific story here, I can do that. Whatever story I go to here in Zotero, if I wanted to save that particular item to my Zotero library, I click on that sheet of blue paper, it's going to pull that right in. As I mentioned in the earlier tutorial, you always want to use a web page, always want to capture the URL, the date it was created if you can find that, and also the date that you visited that page. If I scroll down here a bit, you'll see that Zotero captures for me the URL and the date that I visited that page. So it does a really nice job. That's the minimum information you need to cite. Zotero pulls it in automatically. So you can see that it did recognize this as being a web page. There are billions of web pages out there. Zotero only recognizes a few thousand. So say I'm at a web page that Zotero does not recognize, and unfortunately one of those web pages is our medical library homepage. I don't get any kind of an icon up here. What I can do though, anytime I visit a web page in Zotero, if Zotero doesn't recognize it as being a web page, if I click on this icon here, this will actually make an item from the page I'm on automatically. So if I just click here, it's going to save the Alumni Medical Library page here as an item. I can also see this little arrow next to that particular page here. If I click on this, it actually took a snapshot of the page when I visited it. This is really a nice feature. So I can now click here and look at a snapshot. This is not the live link to the page. This is a snapshot of the page when I visited it. You can also see I have a few options if I want to make notes on this page, that there are four icons up here at the top of the page. If I click on this first one, I can actually add a sticky note any place I want to the web page and make any kind of note, like say, make sure I cite this is important, whatever the case may be. I'm not going to save that though, I don't need it. I can also highlight using this tool right here. I can highlight the text, and anything is now going to be highlighted in yellow. So again, as a way if I want to keep track of something on this page that I want to come back and use later on. So Zotero, this is just scratching the surface, I know, but Zotero is very good at importing journal articles, web pages, and books. Pretty much anything you can find online, you can pull right in. If you're using a resource that Zotero doesn't recognize, you can always make a new entry you can make a new entry manually. If I just click on this icon here, and whatever I happen to be using, say I'm using white paper or something, I could just say document here and just cut and paste the information to make a record myself. So you can certainly use Zotero to capture any kind of information that you come across. So the thing is, like I said, I know I'm just scratching the surface here. We do have linked back to our library page. Oh, sorry, that's my fault. I have to go back to the library page here. This is that snapshot only. I'm just going to go out and go back into our actual library page. So we do, from the BU library page, have a series of tutorials here under the e-resources page, the very bottom tutorials. And we do have some, we do link to some Zotero tutorials right here for other resources and other properties. But I just want to give you a quick overview of how Zotero works. So once you have all of these things into your library, how do you actually use this to help you cite a paper to avoid plagiarism? All you have to do, as long as you downloaded that second feature in the beginning, the Word plugin part, I'm just going to go to my copy of Word back here from my desktop. And I'm going to start typing a paper. So I'm going to say here, here is my first sentence. So say I want to cite this. This is too important of a thought to be left on its own, to be accused of plagiarism. It's way too important here. I'm just going to go up here in my toolbar to add-ins. So this is now what Zotero installs when you download that plugin. I'm going to know the very first icon is Insert Citation. So now Zotero is going to ask me what citation style I want to use. The most popular one in the School of Public Health is APA, so that's fine right here, the 6th edition. Now Zotero is going to ask me which citation I want to use. So I'm just going to hit this little down arrow here and go to Classic View so I can see all of the resources I have. So say in this case I want to cite that book Mountains Beyond Mountains. I'm just going to click on that and say OK. And now it inserts that properly right into my paper in APA style. So say I have a second sentence, so here is a second sentence. And say I want to cite this as well, same thing, I go up to that first icon, which is Insert Citation. I'm going to change this again to go to the Classic View so I can see everything I have. So say I wanted to have multiple citations in this particular line here. So I can just click here where it says Multiple Sources, and using this box on the right-hand side, I can move those things over. So say I want to cite that paper by Farmer and Kim, and then I want to cite that WHO page. I can move them both over here. Say I make a mistake, I want to move this one out. I just hit click the left arrow to move that back out. I can also have citations from multiple folders. So say I also want a citation from this folder here. I could just grab this paper and put that in the box. If I have the order wrong, I can actually move the order up and down in that same citation. So I have a lot of options here to getting the citation exactly right. I'm now just going to click on OK, and now Zotero is going to put those two citations in my paper. Once I'm done, say I've written the entire paper, wherever I put my cursor, I can make a bibliography automatically. If I just go to the third icon over, Insert Bibliography, and click on this, it's now going to make a properly formatted APA bibliography for those sources that I used. This is really a nice feature. Like I said, this is really what you have to do to make sure you don't get accused of plagiarism. You can have Zotero capture your citations and then properly format them in the paper for you. Something we see with students all the time, and this is actually a good problem, say you wrote this paper for a class in APA style, and it's such a good paper your professor wants to see it published in a journal. Say you submit that to a journal that does not use APA style. You don't have to retype your paper. You can have Zotero reformat it for you. If I just go up to the fifth icon over here, sorry, if I go to the sixth one here, my fault, the Set Document Preferences, I can now change the style. So say my article got accepted into JAMA, which uses this AMA style. I'm just going to click here on OK, and now it goes from APA right to AMA style. So you never have to type a paper again. You can always just have Zotero go back and change those citation styles for you.